No, I didn't do it. While the entire nation yearned to face the truth, those were the words that were uttered, and the true nature of those in power was revealed. They reigned by monopolizing power and protected their reputations, all the while spouting lies and deceit. When the public realized all of this, fury, misery, and frustration boiled over. Nonetheless, we never forgot our rights as citizens.
얻으면 빛을 이길 수 없다. 거짓은 참을 이길 수 없다. 진실은 침몰하지 않는다. 우리는 포기하지 않는다.
2016. The nationwide candlelight rallies began as a small spark, but spread like wildfire, heating up the bitter cold winter with a cumulative attendance of 16,852,000 people. During that time, the number of protesters arrested or deceased, zero. The number of rally sites nationwide, 67. Worldwide, 74. These candlelight rallies began on October 29, 2016 and went on until April 29, 2017, over a span of 183 days. The official 23 days of peaceful protests set a tremendous precedent. The Inter-Korean Summit and the North Korea-U.S. Summit created a peaceful mood the entire world experienced. And it was all made possible by one particular event. It all began with a candlelight revolution of 17 million Koreans, an unprecedented series of voluntary rallies led by ordinary citizens. The Korean people, who had been divided by ideology, regionalism, and generation, took to the streets with candles as a symbol of a united heart, a united purpose. South Korea is a democratic republic. All power comes from the people. That was the moment when those words from the Constitution rode the waves of the people's cries into the candlelit square. The candlelight revolution began with roars of, "What kind of nation do we live in?" But the shame of those cries, soon thereafter, evolved into proud shouts of, "This is the kind of nation we live in." It gave inspiration and courage to mankind with the world's democracy at stake. People went out to the square every weekend, trudging through snow, showing their commitment to democracy and justice with a tenacity never seen before. Community spirit that had once been lost was restored in Candlelight Square. We were able to survive the snow and rain, shivering in the cold, because of the warmth and affection we shared. The youth, teenagers to 30-somethings, took the initiative and breathed life into the revolution, creating the greatest hope and legacy of a progressive core, and thus the Candlelight Generation was born. As time passed, the protests became even more electric, but there was patience and order, shouts and marching. The moral fortitude of the peaceful rallies of a million or two at a time overshadowed the need for show of force or violence. The magnificent and beautiful candlelight revolution, a rarity in the history of the world, was introduced to humankind in the 21st century and elevated the national prestige that had fallen to the wayside. This was a scene of a mission that absolutely needed to be fulfilled. people around the world admired the democratic maturity of South Korean citizens and likewise wanted to learn how to express the people's will from a young democracy. In light of all of this, the Frederick Ebert Foundation selected the Koreans who participated in the candlelight demonstrations as the recipients of the FES Human Rights Award in 2017. Through this process, the candlelight revolution became a shining example for human rights, not only in South Korea, but also for the rest of the world. We use light to write this chapter in history together. Darkness cannot overcome light. We won't stop here. Moving forward, it's time to make sure the fury and sorrow we felt isn't repeated again.